Hey everybody, it's Redneck Renegade. You're probably going, what the heck are you doing, Redneck with the flag? Well, it's an exciting day here in the shop. I got my new lathe. I got her set up, got her leveled out. We'll take off Old Glory. Here's my cover. Sorry about the camera work there. But there we go. We got the Laguna Revo 1216. It's got the PWM, the pulse wave motor, which means it has the same torque through all the RPM ranges. It's got a great feature here, magnetic doors. Easy to change the belts. Just pull this handle out, relieve tension. You can move your belt over. It has three different settings for each pulley. Right now I have it set on the high one. I've been running it a little bit, and I will show you how smooth she runs here. Get this nickel to stand up. There we go. I got it set on the high setting. We're running at 3,759 RPMs, and she's rock solid. She's real quiet. Came with a nice holder here for the spur drive and live center. It's got a really cool clamping system for the tool rest. Instead of a bolt going in and into the post, it actually clamps around it. It's a 1-inch post. And I got a 20-inch bed extension that will be here Monday. So I'm going to get set up, and I'm going to turn some over 100-year-old cherry wood from my brother Andy at Mad Dog Survival from the UK. So that's going to be my first turning on the new lathe. Super happy with it. That's weird that it's showing the readout pulsating on my camera, but it's not pulsating, so that's kind of weird. Anyhow, let's see what else is there. It has a forward and reverse, and over here you can take the handbrake off, and I can stick in a 10 to 20 inch outboard lathe bed extension on this side. I can take this off, put an adapter on, and put a Nova Chuck on there, and I can turn, and it comes with a banjo for the out drive, so I can turn larger bowls on there. But right now I'm sitting at a 12 inch capacity for the 12 inch swing for the bowls, and 16 inch for spindle turning. But I'm pretty stoked. I'm going to give her a try. The fit and finish on it is night and day compared to the Harbor Freight, but I also paid a lot more. So should be a lot of fun. I'm going to get set up here. We'll get this wood chucked up, and we'll give her a try.
I said, Grandpa, what's this picture here? It's all black and white, and it ain't real clear. Is that you there? He said, yeah, I was 11. And times were tough back in 35. That's me and Uncle Joe just trying to survive a cotton farm and a Great Depression. If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. Oh, and this one here was taken overseas in the middle of hell in 1943. almost see my breath. That was my tail gunner, old Johnny McGee. He was a high school teacher from New Orleans, and he had my back right through the day we left. If it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. A picture's worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray can cover. You should have seen it in color. This one is my favorite one. This is me and Grandma and summer sun all dressed up the day we said our vows. You can't tell here, but it was hot that June. That rose was red and her eyes were blue. And just look at that smile, I was so proud. That's the story of my. Right there in black and white. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in color. Yeah, pictures worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray can cover. You should have seen it in color. You should have seen it in
Hey, Andy and Wendy, that sure is some beautiful cherry wood from your yard, brother. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much. This is going to have to go to somebody very special. This stuff means a lot to me. I'm going to be using some new products for finishing. I got some gloss sealer and some super high gloss. I got these from Penn State Industries. So we're going to give that a try, see how that stuff works out. Well, that's the first one. I know the lighting's not real good in here, but man, that's some beautiful stuff. I'm real happy with the new finishing projects or products. Really, really happy with the new lathe. I like the ability to adjust the speed on the fly. So I'm gonna check up this other piece and turn the striker handle, and I'll bring you back when it's all done. Hey, everybody. It's Redneck Renegade. Well, I got my first set of handles done on the new lathe. Super happy with it. No issues. This cherry wood from Andy and Wendy from Mad Dog Survival from England is absolutely beautiful, brother. I love it. And I think I know who the lucky recipient is going to be of these. Anyhow, they're just mocked up right now. I'm going to jump off here and get them glued up and we'll catch you all in the next one. Thank you very much. Oh, got to get one last shot of the new lathe. Got a little chips on her. Absolutely love this thing. All right, I wish you all a great day, and we'll see you soon.